Hey guys, thanks so much for stopping by. This is Alan with Mastermind Handyman. Today I'm going to show you how to install a window blind in your home, one that looks like this. This is one that I just finished, and so this one is cool. In fact, it's cordless and it uses just the up and down motion, and then of course it's got the opening and close stick, and that's about it. So I'm going to show you how to install a new one. I'm actually working in another room here in the house, and I'm going to show you how to do that from the beginning. There it is. And of course we have a window here without it. Whatever you have on the window, go ahead and remove that the best way you can. Just tear it out of there. Make sure that there isn't anything, of course, on the frame itself. You see the little holes from the existing brackets. So get those out, clean it out really good. This is a great opportunity too, guys, to clean the windows. And then we'll go ahead and start doing the window one part at a time. So I'll show you what's the hardware that come with it, and I'll walk you through the whole thing. So if you're interested in that, keep watching. As always, hit the notification bell, the like button, post any comments, that you might want to know about installing it in your window. And also too, if you're not yet a subscriber to the channel, guys, I'm going to be uploading a lot more DIY videos, so I don't want you to miss out. And if you are already a subscriber, thanks so much for watching another video. Let's get started installing a window blind in your home. All right, so we're gonna begin by inspecting our hardware. First things, go ahead and find a little box that's inside. Normally, that's where we will see everything that comes with it. And I'm looking for some particular hardware. A lot of times when I'm installing these blinds, unless the customer wants to, I don't. I only install the blinds with what's needed, basically. So in this one in particular, let me show you the box here really quick, actually, while we're here. This is going to be the Home Decorators Collection Cordless blind, basically. It's, I believe, made out of, slas wood. You see that right here, right? Grain texture. Cordless operation for safe and simple use, and durable and moisture resistant. So this is just one of those not too expensive, not too cheap like blind, which is great. You'll see how it's all assembled. It's a straightforward product, to be honest with you. So first thing we're gonna do is we'll find our hardware. And so like I said, I'm looking for these two little pieces, which you'll see me show you where they go. And these are the ones that we can also use to attach to the frame. And I'll show you what I mean. Personally, I'm not going to do that. And then these three little pieces, we're going to use for that face plate that's going to go above the blind. You're probably familiar with it. This one that's going to go over the blind here to kind of cover it, give it character like this. And then all these extra little things, I'll explain in a moment what they are. I'm not going to use it. We have our screw set right here. So go ahead and put that aside. And then the other two pieces that I definitely want are these ones. And these ones are going to go on the side of the blind here, right? Where we're going to cover basically right there to kind of, you know, box it in. And these little ones are going to be the ones that go on the bottom here. Like this, right? So we'll get to that in just a moment. Then of course we have our little stick. I'm gonna show you what that does and how we stick that onto the blind. Now for reference, another thing that we also want are the brackets, and are gonna be these ones. I'll show you what they look like. There are four of them. You're welcome to do three on the minimum or up to four, which are these brackets here. I'll show you how we're going to install those, but basically they're going to snap onto the blind like this, right? Hopefully you can see that. I'll give you a visual. Yep. And then of course, You spread them out. So I can put another one over here, right? Give it some space. 3 and 4. These blinds are not too heavy, so 3 is enough. If you want to kind of make it simple and be done with it, one in the, on the left, one on the right, and then one in the middle. But it's so straightforward that I'm going to actually use all 4 of them. So again, we're going to need these brackets here. So it's up to you if you want to skip one and just do 3 or do all 4. Up to you. And then we have our screw set. All right, so now I'm going to go ahead and position myself using those existing holes, if able. If not, just go ahead and create new holes. That's totally okay. So I'm going to show you what I'm going to do here to kind of begin guiding myself on here. So let's say I start with this one on the right, right? So the bracket is going to go like this. Hopefully you can see that, right? So I'm going to go ahead and bring it in more. And so I'm going to go ahead and put the screw on the one to the right into the little hole. You have the set of screws right here. And I normally do this with my hand first just to kind of position the screw like that. And then I'll get my drill bit and I drill it in place like this. Right? And you'll notice how that bracket is sitting. So you'll have an option to put 4 screws on there. You know, you really just need 2, one on the front and one on the back. If you have extra screws, by all means, pull all 4 so it has more of a solid mount on there. But you notice what I did, I gave it enough space. I did not start it with this one. I started with the one to the right to bring it in a little bit. And I'm gonna do the same thing with all the existing holes to try to align it. The only trick about this, guys, is that you wanna be able to create the same space from the outside in the inside where the bracket is. So you notice the little space right here that I created. I'm gonna do the same thing with this other bracket so that they are aligned the same throughout. Let me show you what I mean with that second one. So I want you to carefully look at the one on the right, space-wise, and how I do the second one the same way. So, and it's always good to align it first to kind of get a feel for it, and then you'll know if you are just right. Now, another trick too, you'll notice the openings on this are good because even if you have it inside there, you can always move it up and down. So keep that in mind to give you more of a control when you're doing this. So if I position my little hole very close to the edge, I still have just the perfect space and distance from the other one. So again, same thing, instead of starting on the left side, I'm gonna start on the right side to bring it a little closer to the center. Same idea, I'll go ahead and put my screw with my hand just to kind of hold the bracket in place. And then I screw it in gently. One thing that I recommend, this is just a tip, when you're screwing it in the same hole, because there's already some wear and tear to it, just do it gently. So when it tightens, it gets a good grip, right? If you go in too fast, you might loosen up that hole. Now you notice how they both begin to have the same space, the same distance, right? You see this little space right here. Actually, I need to bring this one out more. See how this one is closer to the front? It's got this little space right here. This one instead is closer to the front, but it's got a bigger gap. So what I'm gonna do is just loosen this up and slide the bracket forward a bit. Because ultimately you wanna have the same space between the two. Show you what I'm gonna do. Very simple. Go ahead and loosen up the screw just gently. And then I'll slide it out to have the same space as the one to the right, and just about there. Boom. Okay, so let me show you really quick what it's gonna look like. You know, I went and did a couple extra screws. I'm not even gonna finish it. Whatever came with the box, right? You see, I only got two on this, three on this, four on this, right? Whatever extra that I had. One tip is put at least two, one extra on the ones at the end. And then you're okay with just doing two on the ones in the middle, just so that it has more of a foundation to it. And again, depending on how your frame is, most homes should have that aluminum edge and or that 2x4 where you can grab onto, most homes. All right, so the last thing we're gonna do here is, we'll go ahead and assemble the blind together, just the last final pieces to the hardware. And then we're gonna snap it in place and we are good to go. So for example, we have these pieces that we looked at earlier. So you see really quick here, we have this one just to cover it, so it's not open. Go ahead and snap that in there like that. And then we have one for the end here, right? Find the spot, there's gonna be one for the left, one for the right. This one might go on the other side, maybe not, maybe, yep. Let's see this way, looks like it. So try the other one, and there you go. That's how you know this one goes here and the other one on the other side. Snap that on there. Do the same thing on the other side. And then the last thing here is, we're gonna use these little pieces for our cover. You'll notice this piece is gonna go on the top like this, leaving this exposed. Let me show you. And when you do that, don't do it touching any of the wheels inside the blind. Just kind of like, watch it, done. One on this side, one in the middle somewhere, away from the wheel. And then one on the other side. Wait for it to snap, and you know it gripped on there. Done. The last thing we're going to do, guys, is slide it in so that the blind goes in the back of the bracket first on all four of them. You see what I'm going to do here, right? Just kind of sit it on it. Like this, see how it's sitting on the back? As you notice, there's a groove right here on the back, right? So sit it on all four. And before you snap it in place, let's go ahead and nicely center on the wall, right? Give it the same space on both sides. And then, see, like this one was in the way of my bracket, so I'm gonna slide it down a bit, and that's totally fine. Actually, I'll probably put it on this side here. Yep, so it's a little bit more center, perfect. Once you do that, then we'll go ahead and push it in to snap it into that bracket. Just snap it, right? Push it in, and then it will just kind of snap onto the bracket. Very straightforward. Push it in, and then it snaps in place. That's it. That's about all we had to do. And then last thing, we're basically going to slide it down, and I'll show you how we're gonna do that. Right? Slides down, and it goes up, very straightforward. See? Last thing you gotta do here, guys, is get your little stick, remember? That's gonna go in this little hole here. Once you hear that snap and it's locked in place, now you are done. And then the last thing is, go ahead and remove these little cardboards that are here, gently. Get those out. And you are pretty much done at that point. And this is really all you're gonna need, nothing extra. As far as the hardware around the window frame, because it's really pointless. And then, you know, you're welcome to go down a bit more. You're gonna slide it right into your sill like this, so that there's not much of a wobble. And you're good, right here. See? Now, let's not forget one last piece, that face plate. Remember we talked about? Go ahead and look up just a little bit. And you'll notice that these face plates have a grooving right here. See it? You're gonna slide those pieces onto that groove in, but again, get a level from left to right. Make sure it's got a good even look. And then you're gonna slide them in there, one piece first, then snap them. One, then snap them, and you are done. So you do the top one, then push the other one in, and it's done. And there is our blind, basically. Let's go ahead and do a close-up inspection of it. See? Right, and if I bring it a little closer here, you see how those snaps, right, are there holding the plate. And that's about it, guys. Thanks so much for watching yet another video here on Mastermind Handyman. Today we were able to install a window blind. There's gonna be a lot more do-it-yourself videos that I'll be creating all throughout the house. As always, give this video a thumbs up, like it, share it, and I look forward to my next video. Thanks for watching.